Yo, what up, everybody? Welcome to another episode of Toasty's Bad at Dungeon Souls. So, since the last episode came out, there's been a new patch. So, I see something called the Arcane Forge here, so let's see what that's all about. It looks like some sort of crafting system to upgrade your weapons or something. Oh, wow, we got some new characters here, too. I don't remember Wrench being in the game before. But we don't have anything to do with it yet. So let's just start a new game here. After that insane necromancer round we had last time, we got some other new characters here. Because we got quite far in the game. So let's go with a melee class. It's something I haven't done yet. So let's try with the warrior. This was another, fairly large class that we unlocked last time and haven't gotten a chance to play. Something different I'm also doing now is I am using a controller input. And I don't know the controls at all. Alright, looks like it's bumper to attack. So a lot of people were complaining, maybe rightly so, about, loud keyboard noises. Because I got my super loud mechanical, Ducky Zero pro gamer. I'm a pro gamer. But yeah, I got a mechanical keyboard, so it does get a bit loud sometimes, especially for a very active game like this. I'm just trying to figure out how to upgrade my skills here. So far I figured out how to attack. And... oh, here we go. Alright. Let's see. Slash all enemies or creates a moving sword. I think we want all enemies. Yeah. Alright. Cool. How do I get out of this? There we go. And I'm guessing I'm gonna test what that is like after I step on this ruin here. It's been a while since I played Dungeon Souls. I mean, this last run has been going for... that was pretty sick. Alright, that was pretty cool. That last run we had going with the Necromancer was like 4 episodes. That's like a month worth of content there. Alright, gotta upgrade here. How do I do that? Cannot seem to actually move the cursor in any meaningful way. Oh, here we go. Alright, we want to get our defense up, I think. Yeah, there we go. Alright, slowly figuring this out. Getting back into the swing of things. I wonder how you use potions. Well, let's start by just doing that. Is there even a way to use potions? I honestly don't know. And there are only 2 things on this floor, so the Redeemer is already on his way. Wow, that was... didn't even get to look at the shop, because I don't want to die immediately. Should have thought that out more carefully. Alright, we want more defense, and we want to upgrade our main damage, I think. Okay, alright. Still don't know how to use potions. But potions stack now, apparently, which is nice. You get multiples of the same type of potion. It's a nice little addition that they have there. And the whole reason I'm doing this controller input, another reason is because I really like Enter the Gungeons controller. That's a new item, I don't think we've seen that before. That was insane. Alright. Apparently you can only stack twice. Let's see what this new item is, if I can here. Again, cannot seem to move around my inputs at all while in the pause menu. This is still an early access game, so there's bound to be, bugs like this and whatnot. I just wish that something, like controller input would at least be fully functional at this stage in the game. And here we have our first shop here. Expertly avoided that trap, if I say so myself. Alright, we got a detonator, spike ball, magic stick. I think we want detonator, get some AoE damage going. Still trying to figure out how to use those potions. No? Ah, there we go. I just used both of my potions. I mean, that stacking was new in the patch, so they might have not gotten that all fixed yet, but that is somewhat irritating. We did pick up a silver key there, which is nice. Oh, hello, fellow swordsman. hitting these guys so hard they literally explode all over the place. That ability is insane, by the way. Forbidden Library. Do we do it? I think we do, folks. We want to get our magic resist up if that's going to be the case, but I'm going to go for it. You know, YOLO. A. Alright, maybe I have to be next to it, so I'm going to wait for that trap. And. A. I'm pressing A. Nope. We want that up. Why? Nope. Pressing all the buttons. They're not. A. Pressing A. Apparently we're not going to the Forbidden Library, guys. I tried. Can't say I didn't try. Yeah, I think some of these controller inputs really need to be sussed out before this goes to market. Okay, alright. How did I use this before? Yeah, there we go. It's the D-pad. Alright, we really need to kill these archers. Because otherwise we're super dead. Alright, okay. Use health po- Did that even heal me? That didn't look like it healed me. Jesus, man, these archers are ruthless. I thought that would get everybody, but apparently not. Alright, we're just gonna get out of here. And we're going to the Skeleton King. And I have a very bad feeling about this. Alright, we're gonna use our Rage Potions. And then we're just gonna go into our hit thing there. And we're already almost dead. And we died. Alright. So lessons learned. Don't use the controller on this game. It may help with the sound, but it really does not help with the gameplay. I just cannot effectively use a controller when all the, you know, the layouts haven't been finalized, some of the functions aren't working. This game really isn't at the point where the controller is actually playable. So, I guess something you should know. Or maybe I've just been doing it wrong. That's also, like, very possible. So, yeah. I guess I'll see you next time when we give it a go with another character. I really don't like melee characters, so we might try another range guy. Anyway, yeah, I'll see you next time. Peace!